Hopefully you
are. Never know.
We never know. Where are we at? We are in Krakow for the Umbrella Poland Festival.
Yeah. Once again, you are here in Krakow. You've had some trips around and come back to Krakow.
Yeah, but second week in a row.
If anyone is watching us, please let us know if you can hear us. Basically, that's the first question. Yeah. But what we are doing here? We are here for Umbrella Poland Festival.
Yes. We've got a series of talks lined up today. I've done mine already. Big weight lifted off my shoulders now.
Really good talk. You were talking about what? You were talking about sustainable
community contribution business. And just kind of my journey with Umbrella and how that's kind of impacted my life in many ways, good and bad.
So you scared people from community activities, or rather convinced them to do more community work.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And we've just had a nice talk on
from Polish .NET community,
Microsoft MVPs.
Microsoft MVPs, Dev Mentors, and really Microsoft microservices gurus, and their framework called Convy, which is something what's really useful,
really mind-blowing as well, incredibly powerful. I was saying to a few people during the talk, it's like frameworks, loads of different things,
but it makes it so plug- and it used the third-party tool to graph.
Super pluggable.
that was awesome, we have a series of talk ahead. I will use a short, reference point. We still have a talk by Fedosia from Perplex about 10 tips to make our editors love us. Umbrella and Elasticsearch, the talk by Arek from Krakow, from our Polish community. Tools of Our Trade by Sebastian from HQ. Adventures with Alexa, Dealing with Burning Back by David Battersby, and a comparison of Umbrella patterns and practices by Anthony Dang.
That is a kick-ass lineup, a very, very talented set of talks.
This year we focus about around talks, basically. We pack them really tight, you can see it, right? Three talks, a break, three talks, break. That's a beauty of single track. We will ask people later if they use this knowledge, because the portion of knowledge is massive.
For sure. And then this evening, networking, partying, drinking.
We had a small pre-party yesterday.
Small
pre-party. We are joined by some HQ representatives here. There's Avera from Coma team, Runa, product owner from Umbrella, some SWOT representatives, Sebastian from PR team, a lot of amazing people and a lot of great Polish community members who are just using this opportunity to learn about Umbrella and get some information straight from the community members. And we were hacking yesterday a little bit. In our Cogworks Krakow's office. We were preparing some work for pull requests, basically, because we were not able to complete any work items, but we gathered some information to make them complete soon.
Of course.
Because it's Hacktoberfest.
It is Hacktoberfest. That's really nice. Smooth transition. It's Hacktoberfest as of Tuesday, I think it starts.
Yes.
Or if you were in early, like Monday night in Europe, because actually it's from Australia. They kicked off at HQ with a bit of a hackathon about getting people contributing. It looked really productive. There's Ken in the
already
pictures.
Completing the limit.
Yeah,
of
he's probably
requests.
Done. It's four
Sebastian,
requests.
Sebastian
this year,
said. Right? Sebastian said that on 3rd October, Umbrella already had 40 pull requests to review. So it's amazing. So it's going to be an amazing Hacktoberfest. Once again, the numbers will be higher than probably the year ago. And
absolutely.
Four pull requests. You mentioned 4 pull requests are required officially by DigitalOcean and GitHub to complete the Hacktoberfest.
And you get a T-shirt.
And you are all invited to contribute, because Umbrella and other open source projects are looking for people who will dedicate some time to help them in anything, basically.
Exactly.
Documentation, coding, diagrams, architecture, comments, chats, and stuff like that. You don't need to write code responsible for sending rockets to Mars. you can just help in writing documentation to make it more readable.
Exactly. And that's you've mentioned 40 pull requests so far, but there's been some really good examples on Twitter of things that people have done. Lee Kelleher has done his fixing the Umbraco label in V8. So when you click it actually toggles the button. It just makes loads and loads of sense.
Makes sense.
Jevon, I love this one. Jevon and Mark Goodson have done, I'll zoom in a bit there and maybe we can see it.
And Mark, of course, is here somewhere, right?
apparently.
I've seen him.
So this is file name search in the CMS. So before you'd have to search only by, you'd only be able to search on the media item name, but now it's actually the now it's actually the file name too. We're sharing our screen. They can't see it.
I had an idea once about having cognitive services plugged in there and let us people search by content of the picture.
Yeah, that would be fantastic.
Apple and
that would be absolutely fantastic.
We have some other Polish community member representatives here.
Yeah, there was also a fantastic accessibility pull request from Florian. He actually did 5 different issues that he fixed in the space of 1 pull request, which is insanely awesome. That's just chipping away at the accessibility.
We were reviewing this pull request, pull request, because it's part of the pull request and issue on GitHub about accessibility things. It's still ton of the things to be done, right? It's still things to be done, so it's never ending story, and we can always make some Umbraken product better, right? Even with those octopuses in the background.
Yeah, absolutely. What else has happened this week? So we've had
We had Scrift issue.
There was Scrift.
And you wrote an article there, right?
I did write an article. Let's just jump back to the screen share. Not in our usual setups. This is not too comfortable. Yeah. I did write an article. So who moved my cheese, my V8 guide to where the hell everything has gone?
Transition from V7.
Yeah. So it's like, where the hell's the config gone? Yeah. Where's this button in the back office gone to? Quite a lot of stuff. It got some good feedback on Twitter. Neil's even made a meme out of it, which I don't think has been publicly surfaced, but maybe at some point will. It's scary. That's all I'll say. Jan also did a fantastic article on the accessibility of the Umbraken back office, the changes that are happening, and all of the stuff that's coming. So
whole team is really great working team, which is an inspiration for anyone else who is trying to focus on specific area in Umbraken and just do the work, because it's really, really well delivered. Every release of Umbraken has some accessibility fixes in it.
Yep.
So it's amazing.
Yep. Absolutely.
What else? We had a blog post on Umbraken about new hire.
Of
which
course.
Is not so
yeah,
new.
The old new hire of
old new hire. Rasmus.
Rasmus. Because he actually joined, I think, back in like...
It was before Code Garden.
It was before Code Garden, April sometime. But he's joined the headless team. That's lovely, Rasmus.
Yeah,
a little bit about him. I love this picture as well.
Yeah, great.
Him and Morten, headless. Headless. That's really good. It's really, really cool.
Obviously, we forgot about keynote here done by Luna and a lot of insights from Umbraken HQ. We've heard about products. We heard about roadmap and everything, which is ahead in time. Somewhere later in time and next on the roadmap. So that's amazing to see how Umbraken is growing year by year. And those numbers are just
indeed
always great to hear.
And it was announced this morning as well that in 2 weeks' time, I think we should be getting a V8.2 release with, I believe, Runa said 90 bug fixes, which is an insane number of bug fixes, a huge
amount. It was not bug fixes, it was about features.
90
features and issues fixed. Yeah,
right.
That's wow. Features and issues fixed.
Yeah. So, really incredible.
Coming more stable, more performant.
Middle of October.
And we are all looking forward to it.
Yeah. Exactly.
So yeah, it's going to be a great day. Some other communities had meetups. We've seen some tweets on flying around about talks.
Hey, it's Rune.
Rune, how's your day? Is going?
Good.
Yeah. You've delivered a great keynote. Shared some insights from Umbraken HQ. Grab some lunch already, or you're still going there?
I just had lunch.
I just had lunch.
Which was also very good.
We're yet to try it. We'll be down there in a second.
Yeah.
Looking forward for any specific talk or topic around, or maybe you've enjoyed the Convi talk about.
Well, I'm really looking forward to Fedosha's talk, which is next up, I think.
Yes.
About how you can make life better for editors. I've heard it's really, really good, so I'm super looking forward to that one.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's also the talk about Elasticsearch later,
which
I find really interesting.
Yeah.
Cool.
We were saying that there's a huge range of topics. It's like packed full.
Yeah.
Of some really great stuff.
great lineup.
Yeah,
that's all for us. That's all for community members, and let's learn together and let's share this knowledge. I'm hoping that people are exchanging knowledge right now downstairs, and that's what it's all about, because it's not only about talks but the social aspect of it. And great to have you here. Great to have you here.
So happy to be back.
Yeah, that's awesome. We probably don't have anything else to share.
No, news-wise, we've been a bit out of touch, I think.
Yes,
because traveling, busy getting here and partying. If we find some more news, we'll make sure it's listed in the description.
Yeah, and keep us all updated what's going on in your houses, offices, and stuff like that, because we are coming back to Umbraco Poland Festival, and we will send a big high five for everyone who's here, and I'm more than sure the people from here are sending not kisses, high fives for you. And thanks for being us with here, being with us here, and see you next Friday.
See you next Friday.